geneticists are particularly interested in studying cases where Mendelian inheritance doesn't appear to happen. And the question is, why would non-Mendelian inheritance happen? So in this video, I'm going to show you how to perform a chi-square test to compare observed phenotype data from a cross and their predicted data to reveal non-Mendelian inheritance. And in this case, we're going to discuss this mutation in mice called the yellow mutation, which produces this mouse that's shown on the left. This mutation is also called the agouti mutation, or an agouti mouse. And these mice have multiple traits that occur when this mutation causes coat color to change. In contrast, the mouse on the right is a wild type mouse. The yellow mutation is dominant to the wild type coat color allele of this gene. But despite that, in 1905, Quineau published the results of a cross between a yellow mouse and a wild-type mouse. And what Quineau never saw, despite the fact that the yellow allele is dominant, a litter of mice that was entirely yellow. Instead, when Quineau produced this cross, he always saw a mixture of some yellow and some wild-type coat-colored offspring. Interestingly, even when this cross was set up between two yellow mice, the ratio of offspring was not the 3-to-1 phenotype ratio that would be predicted under Mendelian expectations if these two parent mice were both heterozygotes, capital Y over lowercase y. Instead, the phenotype ratio tended to be more like 2 yellow for every 1 wild type mouse. Now let's perform a chi-square test to compare the observed number of yellow and wild type offspring in this cross to the expected numbers in either situation where there was a 3-to-1 ratio or a 2-to-1 ratio of yellow to wild type offspring.